I received a package from Prusa. So, what's in there? On April 1st, 2023, Prusa revolutionized the 3D printing industry by introducing the next generation of 3D printing filament. Instead of sticking to the usual round shape, they introduced a filament with a hexagonal cross section. I will take a look if this is really the revolution we were promised, or if it falls short of our expectations. The filament was shipped in one of the usual Prusa cardboard boxes. I liked that Prusa moved away from the unreasonable plastic wrapping. The outer box had a few smashes, but the filament boxes are unharmed. After taking the spool out of the box, the nice transparent side plate can already be seen. This design allows us to see how much filament is left on the spool with ease. As always, getting the beginning of the filament out of its slot is a bit tedious, but I managed to do it with the help of my caliper. The difference to normal round filament is definitely noticeable, but actually a bit hard to capture on camera. The filament features Prusa's usual inspect your spool online feature. Here we can see information about this exact spool. I'm not sure if I can believe the 100% hexagonality though. I also noticed that one of my other spools was actually manufactured on the 2nd of April. In Prusa Slicer I noticed there's a new update. Sadly, there is nothing about the new hexagonal filament in the release notes, just some unimportant arachne perimeter generation stuff. And I can confirm, there is really no special profile for the filament. So, I'm slicing a Benchy with the normal Prusament PLA profile. I tried uploading the model via Wi-Fi, but that sadly failed. So I took my reliable USB stick, and ejecting failed. So I just took the unejected USB stick and injected it into the printer. I really like the one-click printing feature, but whoops, I forgot to change the filament. Since the change filament option didn't work, I had to stop and restart the print. I'd call that a successful change. And here it is. Quality wise, I think the Benchy looks quite good, but it does have some inconsistencies. The comparison to this black Benchy might be a bit unfair, but I do think the black one looks a bit better. We can see that there is a quite visible difference between the layers that might be a result of the hexagonal shape. I also printed a hexagonal gridfinity pin, this time manually setting the infill to be hexagonal, since, as I mentioned earlier, there is sadly no print profile to do this automatically. The print quality is good, but slightly inconsistent again, and just so you know, the bin does not fit the standard gridfinity grid. So, all things considered, Prusa's hexagonal filament certainly brings a new and interesting innovation to the 3D printing industry. The transparent side plate is a practical addition that allows users to easily monitor the remaining filament. However, it's disappointing that there isn't a dedicated slicer profile for this new filament. I have three spools, so I'm prepared for all possible circumstances. But is it really a revolution? And is it the future of filament? I guess only time will tell. So stay tuned and bye!